Okay, guys, Chayance is back with the topic. Do not try to impress a man with your fake impressionalism. Yes, I'm back with the topic, guys. Happy Sunday, happy Sunday, happy Sunday. My network has been really messy. And I'm trying my best to make sure everything is intact now with the network. And also, I got distracted by people calling my phone, sending messages. So you know how this works. Everybody's got something to share. Yes. The topic continues. You know, the caption is the same. Okay, about relationship. So, but before we go into this, let us enjoy this music. You were great. You were great. Oh, you were great. You were great. Say you were great. Everything reading about you is great. Yes, we continue with the song. Invite your friends to join this video. Invite your loved ones, because this is an interesting topic over relationships, and you don't want to miss it. You don't want them to miss it either, and you don't want to be the one who's going to be the translator or the one who's going to be explaining what Chayance said in the videos. So please, do yourself and them a favor by inviting them to join this video. And we're going to take it easy. We're going to take it one step at a time, because we are trying to get back on track. And this video is a continuation of the first video I was doing, okay? About not, impress a man with your fake impressionalism, trying to fake pregnancy, trying to fake that you're the best, trying to fake everything fakeable just for him to keep you, okay? So let me tell you, commit to you. He knows where his heart is. I've always told you this. A man knows what he wants. A man knows where his heart is. A man knows what he wants from a lady. So when he's not ready to have a child, do not go as far as wanting to hold him back, down with the pregnancy, or even trying to fake it so you can get the attention. Okay, so that's what this topic is about this night, this morning, early morning. This morning is 2016, December the 5th. Is it 5th or 4th of December? I am not sure. So who's sure about the date? Mercy Tega, yes, I see you joined again. Thank you for joining. Good morning to you. Nana Linda Ugunta, hey, my sister, it's been long I saw you. Nice you joined me this morning. God bless you for joining. And you should know, whatever we do, it's not by our strength, it's not by our power, it's not because we are the most brilliant or the most successful people in life, but just because it is the will of God that we are alive this morning. And I really thank God that I am alive this Sunday morning also to share with you. Some of you are getting ready to go to church. Some of you are already in the church. Some of you will go later. And some of you will go tomorrow. But whatever the case is, always remember that you have God as your source of whatever you do, your source of income, your source of joy, your source of happiness, your source of protection, okay? Your source of inspiration, of encouragement, your source of upliftment. So I am you is great. Yes, thanks for joining, GU Vera. I see you joined me this morning in this topic, this talk show. Okay, this topic now, let's hit the point. Oh, you are great. Let me give time for more people to join me, because I'm loving it. Everything reading about you is great. You were great. You were great. You were great. You were great. Daddy, you were great. Woo. Yeah, you were great. You were great. Everything written about you is great. Yes. Everything written about you is great, okay? So you do not go as far as wanting to be like somebody else, wanting to hold a man with a pregnancy because you thought, okay, this man is not giving me attention. This man, I've done all my best and he cannot keep me. He's having side chicks. He's keeping other women. He's sleeping with other women. And you think the best option now is to just lie, to say that you're pregnant. You have come again. Yes, come in. Yeah, so make sense. Okay. It's good. It comes so now. So guys, yes, I have to. Okay, you know what? Which whenever I do my videos, I'm not alone. I always have a crew, and that is my kids. And yes, they need attention just as much as I want to give attention to you guys and to discuss this topic with you. Let me just make it as short as possible. Probably make a part three of this video. But this is about a lady who. Thank you for joining Don Jalisco and Rita Asemota Gold. Thanks for joining. I see you joined me. Pepe Chidi, good morning. Good morning to you, Rita. Happy Sunday, beautiful lady. Thank you so much, my sister. Nice to see you. Nice to meet you here this Sunday morning. And this topic this morning, okay, it's about do not be so fake. Huh? Don't be fake. Keep it real. Keep it real in your relationship. Be honest in your relationships because you don't know where you're going to meet somebody tomorrow. A lady sent me a message over her issues where she lied to her man that she was pregnant and she wasn't pregnant. And the guy got excited over the news and went to his family that he's gotten his girlfriend impregnated. So only for her to got confused in the end. And was like, oh my God, what have I done? The whole family is interested in this pregnancy. They want to know me. They want to meet me. And I am not pregnant. I am not pregnant. I just lied to him that I was pregnant. So she was asking me, what should she do? What should she do in a situation like this? Where you think, okay, this man is not giving me attention. This man is going with other ladies. This man doesn't want to be there. He doesn't want to commit to me. So I want to lie to him. I want to make him to give me attention. I want to make him to give all his time to me by telling him that I am pregnant. But I know deep down in myself that I am not pregnant. I am just lying and faking it. Okay, so now she sent me this message and I was wondering to myself, I was thinking to myself, what should she do in a situation like this? What is the next move she should make? How can she make it up to this guy, okay? One thing I believe, I haven't asked her actually what was her motive, okay? What was her reasons for telling this guy such huge lies? She was insecure from my opinion. She was insecure. Probably she doesn't trust this guy. Probably she thinks that the guy is going with other ladies. Probably she thinks that if she tells him that she's pregnant, she's going to get all the attention. She's going to distract him from seeing other women. She's going to make him to introduce him to his family. Of course, now he has heard the news that you're pregnant and you are not pregnant. And he's told his family and his family wants to meet you. So what is she going to do? How can she make it up to the guy? Because I feel that this lady loves this guy, but this guy is not giving her what she wants. And she feels like, okay, I'm going to lie. I'm going to tell him I'm pregnant, and then I'm going to get him to give me all the attention that I deserve, all that I want. The truth, yes, LOL, yes, Pepe Chidi, thank you. Sheila Jolly Ebe, thanks for joining, Sheila. Nice to see you. Kosiko Chuku, hey, it's been a while I saw you. Try to get pregnant to him within a few days. Yes, that's what I was wondering. How is she going to make it up to him? Is she going to get him to sleep with her every day until she gets pregnant to make it up for the lies that she's told? And how is he going to go to his family to tell them that, hello, My girlfriend is not pregnant. She lied to me. I mean, is she going to come up with a story that she got miscarried? Is she going to say that she aborted the baby? So at the end of the day, you are only making yourself miserable. You're only putting yourself in danger. You're only putting yourself in a situation where you're not going to be able to defend yourself in the future. Okay, let's take for instance that this guy, you told him the truth now, because my suggestion was that she has no other option but to come out plain, come out clean and say, hey guy, I wasn't pregnant. I lied to you. Because that is the only way you can sleep, okay? With your heart intact, with your mind intact, and to have your peace. Whatever action he's going to take later shouldn't be your problem. But what your problem now should be is that you have confessed to him that you lied to him. You have told him, hey, this is the reason. And I'm sure he's going to ask you, what were your reasons for even lying to me in the first place? Okay? What were your reasons for lying to me in the first place? Were you insecure? Were you scared I'm going to go with another woman? Were you scared I'm not going to marry you? What were your, was your reason for you to tell me that you are pregnant and actually you're not pregnant? And I got so excited. I went to my family. I told my family, hey, my girlfriend is pregnant for me with a baby, maybe a boy and a girl, a future president. You know what I'm saying? So, ladies, like I've always said, before you put yourself in this situation, discuss with a man if he's interested in having a future with you. Discuss with a man if he's interested in having kids with you. Discuss with a man if he's interested in getting married to you. Discuss with a man what is the next step after 6 months. Where is this relationship taking me? Because insecurity can make you lie. Insecurity can make you put yourself in situations where you cannot be able to take yourself off. Okay, say he forgives you tomorrow and then he wants to get pregnant with you and then you are not able to get pregnant. As at the time he was so desperate to get pregnant and his family wants you to get pregnant and they want to marry you. They like you for who you are, exactly. They just love you. He loves you for who you are. But now you have ruined everything by going to lie to this poor guy or this rich guy or this guy who just wants to spend his life with you. To say that you're pregnant when you are not pregnant and his family knows it, okay? If this guy did not go to tell his family about this incident, it was a different case. But now the family is involved, okay? They are probably making arrangements to go and pay your bride price, to welcome you as a wife into the home, into the family. And now this is what they are going to get. Oh, sorry, I lied. Oh, sorry, I had miscarriage. Oh, sorry, I aborted the baby. Oh, my God, for God's sake, you want to be somebody's wife tomorrow. How can he continue a relationship with a liar? How can he trust you again in the future? Even when you get pregnant now, this guy, you can come up and say, guy, boo, I'm pregnant. And the boo will tell you, man, you're fucking kidding me. You're not pregnant the first time you lied to me. I can trust you. How am I sure this pregnancy is for me? Because I don't know how many guys you have lied to that you're pregnant. I don't know how desperate you are to settle down. I don't know how desperate you are to have a child. But do not lie to any man or woman, okay, in your relationship. So, before I continue, let me go to your topics, to your comments, to your opinions. Emmanuel Wankwo, I see you joined me. Happy Sunday, yes. Kosiso, yes, I see you. The truth, yes, LOL. I'll try to get pregnant, yes. That's what I thought. Azu is watching, Azu, I see you. Reti Susie, nice to see you here. Thank you for joining. Happy Sunday, beautiful sister. I know Yafe Emi. Nice to see you. Yes. Good morning, dear. Yes, good morning, Susie. Good morning to you. Oh, yes. Let me like your comments. Azu on point. Yes, I always, the King Lady, always on point. Sarah Otunabu. If you are pregnant and you tell him you are pregnant and he don't want the baby, what do you do? Okay, that's a good question coming in from Sarah Otunabu. Sarah Otunabu just asked the question, if you are pregnant for a guy, dating a guy, and along the line you got knocked up, okay, and you tell this guy that you've been knocked up, and what was... And he doesn't want the baby. Okay, if he doesn't want the baby, what are you going to do? Now, this question is directly to the King Lady Chayans. If you are pregnant and you tell him you are pregnant and he don't want the baby, what do you do? My answer to that question is that what do you do is that you have to summon courage to have your baby. You have to summon courage to keep your baby, okay? I'm not going to advise you to go for abortion. Okay, my glasses is messing up now because I've lost weight. So I'm trying to fix it. Okay, so you don't tell a guy when he doesn't accept the baby, you go ahead and have your baby. You get help. You look for help as much as you can because abortion is murder. You don't know the child you're going to abort because a guy rejects you, because he doesn't accept the pregnancy, because he thinks it's not time for me to settle down, or my parents doesn't love you, or I don't really love you, I just wanted to have fun with you, or you got raped and along the line you got pregnant. My sister, from what I have learned from experience, I would not advise you to go for abortion. I would advise you to seek help from, you know, mature people, family people, who knows the value of having a child. Who knows the value of, okay, you give up your education, you give up your job, you gave up a lot of things just to make sure that you bring this child into the world. You should take that risk because the worst thing you can do in your life is not to take risk. A lot of people are scared of risk and that's why they go for abortion. They are scared of what are people going to say. I have a child out of wedlock. I have a child when I am in secondary school. I have a child when I have not finished my university. I have a child with a guy who's not ready to marry me. I have a child with a guy who's promised me heaven and earth, but this guy is not ready to commit to me. But my sister, when the mistake has been done, it has been done. Okay? So you have made a mistake of not protecting yourself by using contraceptives. You have made the mistake of not protecting yourself by using condoms or whichever way you can protect yourself from having unwanted pregnancy or having sexually transmitted diseases. The mistake has been made. So when the child is there in your womb as a lady, as a mother of two cute kids, two intelligent, brilliant heroes that I have in my life, if those kids came into my life, as at the time I wasn't prepared to get married, I wasn't prepared to have a child, I wasn't prepared, or the guy was not prepared who got me pregnant. Okay, I got this pregnancy by rape. My sister, my brother, what I am going to do is to keep my child. I am going to ask God, the source of life, to protect me, to, you know, to give me the courage, the strength to keep this child and to provide me with the source to cater for this child. Because I do not know the future of this child. If God did not want this child to come into this world, God will not let me get pregnant by mistake. So no matter how you came into this world, you are meant to come into the world. Do you understand? You are meant to come into the world. Whether you came into the world by rape, you came into the world by wedlock, you came into the world by true marriage, you came into the world that your parents got married and along the line they got divorced, or you came into the world that your parents got married and along the line one of your parents died. So, whomever you are in this world, whether you are an orphan, you are in the motherless baby home, whichever way you came into this world, if the creator of life did not want you to exist, you would not exist, not even in your mother's womb. Okay? When a man releases a sperm, when a man comes in you as a lady, when he releases, the sperm has millions, millions of lives in them. But it is the one, the two, the three, the four, the five that decides to survive in this womb that are actually going to survive. And the ones that God has chosen to say, you are going to come into the earth because you have a purpose. Okay, you have a purpose and that is why you existed. That is why you germinated in your mother's womb like a seed. Okay, so that is a seed that has been planted in. Okay, sorry, I got distracted by your message from my Nollywood actress Shanjot. Shanjot, thank you. I got your WhatsApp message now, but I am now live on Facebook. I'm going to reply to you later. So Azu said, but why must she take? Okay, let me see. Let me read your comments so I'm not being selfish and make it boring by talking too much and not listening to you. I have to listen to you, my audience. Good morning. Yes, I'm point. Yes, if you're pregnant, so that's what I'm explaining. Yes, that is the truth. But Sheila Jolly Ebe, you said yes, that is the truth, but the guy will never have trust in her again. What she needs to do, she should try to get pregnant, period. Okay, yes, you are right about that. I thought about that actually, like to make up for it, okay, get pregnant. But this guy also, pregnancy does not hide. It's gonna calculate from the time you told him you were pregnant and the time you got the second pregnancy. Okay, say you were, for instance, you got pregnant in April, or you lied in April to him that you were pregnant, okay, and he told his parents, okay, before you even meet your pregnancy, it should be at least 2 months, okay? You didn't see your period this month. Say we are in December, you didn't see your period in December. And then in January, you can say, okay, I didn't see my period in January also, so I am pregnant. I am very, very sure I am pregnant, because periods, some people see their periods twice a month. Some people see their period twice a month. Some people, they are pregnant, they don't even know they are pregnant. They still see their periods, okay? This is just things, the hormones in your body is different. Everybody is different. Some people do not find out they are pregnant until the pregnancy is like 3 months gone, or 6 months gone, or 5 months gone. You understand? They still bleed. They still bleed 1 or 2 days. They are not sure what is wrong with them. They don't go for checkups. They don't go to find out exactly. Sometimes you even go for tests, and it says you're not pregnant. Meanwhile, you're pregnant. So nobody really knows what is going on in our body. Nobody really knows. So for you to say, I have lied to him that I am pregnant in April, I told him in May. Okay? And then in June, he told his parents. You're counting from May when you missed your period. You're counting from May. You missed your period in May. That's already 1 month gone. Okay? The moment you miss your period, you are 1 month gone. You are 1 month gone in the pregnancy. Okay? So, May, you don't have signs. So, it's not there. June, it's not there. July, okay? And the parents, the families, they are all waiting to see a sign, or they want to take you to prenatal or antenatal. You know what I'm saying? So, at the end of the day, you're going to embarrass yourself at the hospital. You're going to embarrass yourself at the family's gathering. You're going to embarrass yourself in any ways possible. So even trying to get pregnant in July or in May or in, where you have lied in April that you're pregnant, it's not gonna work, because the guy is gonna find out, hello, you told me in May that you were pregnant, okay, and then because I told my parents and you're not pregnant, and then you lied, and then you got pregnant in June or July. So when the baby comes, it's 9 months, you have 9 months to deliver your baby, they're gonna calculate. And you should be able to go for antenatals when you're pregnant, to know what's going on in your body, to know how many babies are coming, to know if the baby is going to be deformed or not deformed. If you're with a couple that have not done any test before you got pregnant, you have to go for tests for sexually transmitted diseases, so you're not going to infect your children with it. You don't know if you have AIDS, you don't know if you have chlamydia, you don't know if you have gonorrhea, you don't know if you have anything that is going to make this child to be deformed. So having pregnancy, it's not just boom, I am pregnant, okay, that's it, and then the guy begins to give you the attention. There are necessary steps you have to take also during the pregnancy. You have to go to the medical care for them to check you, for them to scan the baby. If it's a boy, you know, you do scanning, you do all that kind of stuff to know if the baby is a boy or it's a girl. So you can't just come up and say, I am pregnant, and then you expect that it's going to be okay, just like that, just by lying to the guy. Now, this guy is believed to you that you're pregnant, and you're not pregnant, and he's told his family. So what are you going to do? My own advice to you is that you have to come out clean. You have to come out to say, yes, I am not pregnant. I lied to you. Okay? If he forgives you, he forgives you. If he doesn't, okay, move on. But then, this has spoiled your reputation, because this guy could come across somebody who is interested in you in the future, and he's going to ask questions and say, hey, who's this lady? You know, I like this lady, Chayanne's. And I want to settle with her. I like what she does. I like whatever she does. I just want to be with this lady. And then the guy is going to, you know, open. When breeze blows, how we should go open. The guy will now open the story. Say, ah, that girl. That Chayans, not mine now, but Chayans too, they lie. Chayans lied to me. I used to date Chayans now. Chayans lied to me, saying she get pregnant. Meanwhile, she not get pregnant. And I already tell my family. So this Chayans, you know, if he trust her finish, you understand? From there, the guy go waka. He go say, Abba. So this babe, way fine like this. This babe now liar. This babe not they trustworthy. This babe now just, he won't use her own desperation. He won't hold me down. You understand what I mean with picking? You understand? So, but, if you're pregnant and you tell him, yes, I've answered that question. Sheila, he said, yes, that's the truth, but the guy will never have trust in her again. What she need to do, okay, yes, I've answered that one. Okay, so like I said, even trying to hold him down with pregnancy for real, it's also not going to work, because if this guy doesn't love you, he doesn't love you. Don't try to impress him because he's not giving you the attention, because you're not getting what you want from him, and you think that pregnancy is the solution. It's not, because a guy could also say, okay, have the baby, and after you have this baby, he's going to go ahead and marry somebody else where his heart is. So then you're left with being a baby mama, not his wife. Okay? And you're more classy when you're his wife than when you're a baby mama. Because a baby mama. I want you to be enjoying this, my glass that is falling upside down. Because a baby mama is like a side chick. A baby mama, you didn't pay her bride price. A baby mama was not introduced. Probably introduced, but you know, you don't have that confidence to say, if anything happens to this man tomorrow, I am the one they are going to call as his wife. I am the one who's going to stand there. And I am the one who's going to say the final goodbye to him. I am the one who he slept with last before he gave up his last breath. Okay, so, Ganu Shele, I don't know what that means. She should try to be pregnant within few days. But what if she's not ovulating? Before you get pregnant, you have to be in your ovulation. Okay, and some people even ovulate, they try to get pregnant when they are ovulating, but yet the pregnancy does not come. So I'm going to feed my kids. Let me quickly answer this. I'm coming. Paul, give me 5 minutes. Let me finish it. But pregnancy always run in the kind of situation. Yes, pregnancy mostly comes when you do not need it, when you do not expect it. Okay, so but when you're desperate to get pregnant, you don't get pregnant. You're locking yourself up, you're stressed. You're looking forward to it with all hopes, with everything you have. You go to church, you pray for pregnancy. You go to Babalawo, you pray for pregnancy. You do everything just to get pregnant. But that doesn't come. The pregnancy will only come when God wants it to come. Okay, so, but pregnancy always run in this kind. Okay, click the share button. Yes, guys, please share. Reti Susie, thank you for sharing this topic. True talk. Yes, Azu, true talk. Amike Musa, I see you're watching, Azu. But why must she take in? Because last I checked, women know one women know one to the body. Azu, what did you say? Last I checked, women know when to when the body is free or not. They don't want condom. Talking about that, okay, with using contraceptives, so using protections when you're having sex, has to do with both people who are involved. Okay, and another thing, people get pregnancy from different ways. People get pregnancy from rape, people get pregnancy from marriage, people get pregnancy out of wedlock. Okay, whichever ways, even when you are in marriage, you can have unwanted pregnancy. And that is why couples who knows, who have family planning, you go into family planning and you begin to use contraceptives. You don't want to get unwanted pregnancy. Unwanted pregnancy does not just come when you are not married. It comes also when you are married, because you could be having family planning. You could say, okay, I just want to have two children. I just want to have one child. I just want to have two kids. But if you do not protect yourself as a woman and you're very fertile, you can always get pregnant. And then abortion is not a solution. Okay? So condoms also can disappoint you. Contraceptives can disappoint you. That is one thing you must know. But still, if you're not ready to nurse a baby, if you're not ready to father or mother a child, you should always protect yourself. And then if it happens, it happens. Okay, if it happens, then okay, I did my best, but this pregnancy came. Okay, but do not lie when you are not. Okay, this topic is about lying, faking pregnancy. Actually, it is against the law. In a developed country, when you lie to a guy, that guy can sue you for faking pregnancy. Do you understand? When the guy knows his mission, he knows his rights, he can sue you. A guy can sue you for faking pregnancy. Do you understand? A guy can actually sue your ass off. Go to his lawyer and lie, because you're messing with his own life. You're messing with his, what do you call it? Fertility. You're messing with his fertility, okay? So maybe it's a guy who actually, he wants you, he likes you, but there are things you're doing that he doesn't like, and it makes him to be in doubt over being in a relationship with you. And you have already noticed that this guy does not want to be with you. This guy is not, okay, he doesn't want to hurt you, but he's just pretending, he's just playing along. And then you think, okay, I'm going to have a fake pregnancy. I'm going to deceive him with a fake pregnancy so that he's going to give me the attention, so that he's going to give me the love that I need, so that he's going to give me everything that I need, so he's going to settle with me, he's going to pay my bride price. And you're not sure. In your mind, you thought, okay, if I told him, he's going to say, oh, I am not the only one you're dating, I am not responsible for your pregnancy, oh, you have to have an abortion, and you try it. That guy might just say, oh my God, you're pregnant for me? Are you serious? Oh my God, I want to introduce you to my family. I want to marry you. I want to have a child with you because you're beautiful. Because if we have a child together, this child is going to be really cute. Okay, so men and women have so many reasons why they want to go into a relationship and have a child with a person. Maybe because this couple, they look together, they look cute together, and they say, oh, if we have a child together, it's going to be cute. Okay, but that does not define that you have to be together for the rest of your lives. Do you understand? Yes, you are right, my sister. Ab Ebiro, thank you very much. Thank you. I appreciate your comments. You are right. Yes, Sarah Tunabu, yes. Thank you, guys. Okay, lovely topic. Yes, thank you, Sarah. Azu, I beg, girlfriend, don't take in when I'm not ready, because I still have many things to do before marriage. If you take in, you are on your own for now. Yes, you see, so this is Azu saying, telling his girlfriend or whomever that is in his life from those videos that she shouldn't take in when he is not ready, because if she takes in, she is going to be on her own. So why don't you think like this, ladies? This is coming from a guy, from a gentleman, Azu, an Eastern Nigerian. So this is an advice, okay? Also to guys, some guys also, they want to use pregnancy to hold a woman down. It's not just ladies who want to use pregnancy to hold a man down. Some men want to use pregnancy because the woman is independent, because the woman will be asking them for money, because the woman has everything she needs, and because they think the woman can bring them abroad. They can go abroad with the woman, okay? The woman, if they have pregnancy, then the woman automatically is going to give them paper to live abroad, give them visa. So there are so many men out there also who want to use pregnancy to hold down a woman. And these are not just white or black men. In fact, it's all over the world. Indian, Asian, blah, 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 interracial, mixed, or same ethnicity. One way or the other, one or the two wants to use one to have pregnancy, and from the pregnancy they feel that they have the way into the person's life and to reap where they did not sow. So all those things are just all couples back to you being honest to yourself, because you can have that visa, you can have that passport, you can have all that you needed, but you don't have the man, you don't have the woman, okay? Or the next person you're going to meet is one who's going to really show you pepe. You know, show you pepe. Sarah, you said you're too much. Thank you, Sarah. Thank you so much. Ahaha, at Azu. Yes, yeah, so Pepe, laugh at Azu. Azu just said his mind, and actually, he's speaking from a man's perspective, okay? So when a man is not ready, a man is not ready. It doesn't matter what you want to use to hold him down. Pregnancy, monkey style, Django lover style, any style you do. If a man doesn't want you, he doesn't want you. A man will take his child and they will say, fuck the lady. Let her go look for somebody else. I don't want to settle with a lady who insults me. I don't want to settle with a lady who does not keep the home intact. I don't want to settle with a lady who's flirting. I don't want to settle with a lady who every man has her social media contact. Okay, so a lot of reasons why men don't want to settle, and a lot of reasons why women don't want to settle. But when it comes to pregnancy, do not fake it. But then again, when the pregnancy is there, oh, please keep the baby, because this baby is going to take care of you. If you train the baby good, if you believe in God, if you say, okay, God, it is your will that this child came into my life. I was raped to have this child. I was molested. I was in any way not ready to have this child. This is an unwanted pregnancy. But please, God, help me. Provide for me. Okay, my parents do not want this child. My boyfriend do not want this child. Even my friends are advising me to have an abortion so I can be able to further my education. But Lord, I need your strength. I need your wisdom. I need your understanding over this situation, because it has happened. Forgive me for my sins and provide for my child. Provide for me, so that I can raise up a good child. Who knows who the child will become tomorrow? This child can become a president. This child can become anything in the future. But Lord, I hand this child over to you. Okay? And I need you to provide for me so I can be able to take care of my child without begging, without even inconveniencing anybody, in order to put food on the table for my child and for myself. And provide so that I can have another man if the father rejected this child. Let me have a man who's going to, you know, adopt this child as his own, love this child as his own, and provide for this child as his own. God answers prayers. It is what you ask for, you're going to get. Abortion is not a solution. And lying to a man to hold him down, or a woman to hold her down with a pregnancy, is neither a solution to, you know, settling or having the commitment that you need or you deserve in your life. So if a man doesn't want to commit, he doesn't want to commit. No matter how you do it. If you like, give him your ass. Let him fuck your asshole. He will not commit to you. Because some guys are gay. They are even in a relationship with a woman. They pretend to be straight, but they are not straight. They are fucking another man. They are in love with another man. So a lot of shit is going on in a relationship where you would say, okay, I want to hold him with a pregnancy. What if the man is bisexual? What if he sleeps with both men and women? And then your pregnancy cannot even hold him down because he's addicted to fucking a man's ass. Do you understand what I'm saying? So the only thing you need in your life now is God. And to protect you from all these men who are going to give you unwanted pregnancy. Or protect you from women who are going to give you unwanted pregnancy that you cannot further your education. You have to take odd jobs to put food on the table for a child you did not even bargain for. Do you understand? So it is not the fault of the children when you bring them into the world out of your carelessness. Do not molest those children. Do not, you know, abandon them or abort them, whatever. Because if God did not want those children to come into this life, they would never come into this life. And there are some kids that no matter the amount of abortion you go for, they will never get off your womb. Those are destined children. They are destined to live. So every soul that is existing in this life was destined to live, was destined to be born. No matter how they came into this life, they were just destined to be born. And the only thing you owe them to have peace in this life is to let them be born and be responsible for them as their parents. Do not give them up to motherless baby, to this, to that, because you don't know. Some of you give up your children and later you want these children back. Eh? You want them back. But you could have taken the risk of saying, yes, I want to be a mother. I flex. I don't flex, so I don't go club. I don't do this. Yes, now I'm knocked up. So now I want to settle. Huh? Some of you, even when you're going to school, you have opportunities of people want to sponsor you. Along the line, when you get knocked up by a guy who's not ready to take care of the pregnancy, or a guy who just raped you and got you pregnant out of molestations, you know, so the best thing you can do for yourself as a human being is to keep this child and give this child a good life as much as you can. Do your best to keep the child. If this child then dies along the line, you have done your best to protect it, to protect the child. Okay? So don't go dumping them in bins, in toilets, or abort them, or begin to blame them. Even when you have them, begin to blame them because their father abandoned you, because their mother abandoned you. You begin to put all the stress. You transfer all your aggressions to your child, who's just as innocent as anything. Do you understand? So as innocent as at the day you met the woman who you got pregnant to provide this or to produce this child, you should be able to take responsibility. Yes, prayer is the key. Rita Asemota, thank you very much. Prayer is the key. We have to be prayerful so that we do not meet the wrong people who are not meant for us. And, you know, to avoid all this drastic life and, you know, things we cannot be able to handle. But I also believe that God does not give you a load. God cannot give you a load you cannot carry. God cannot make you get pregnant when he knows that you cannot provide for this child. So do not take laws into your hand by aborting the child, by faking it or whatsoever. If God doesn't want you to get pregnant for this guy, or God does not want this woman to get pregnant for you, it will not happen. Only when it is the will of God, and you should be able to recognize also the source of your life, the source of your existence, the source of your living is the Creator who gave you life, because science did not give you the breath. Technology did not give you that. Okay? What gave you that is the spirit being who created you, the universe. So when you get up in the morning, whatever your situation is, always thank God that you saw the day. Because then if you made mistakes yesterday, you can be able to correct your mistakes for today. And also ask for repentance so you don't, you know, and strength so you don't continue to make the same mistakes that are going to lure you into sins. That are going to, you know, prevent you from actually getting what God has prepared for you in store. Because God, anybody he puts in this life, the life has already been designed. Okay, God designed your life before he put you on this earth. He designed your life that when you come, you're going to be a talk show host. You're going to be this. You're going to be a doctor. You're going to be that. Still, he gave you the freedom to choose what you want to become. So you only become what you believe. You cannot become what you do not believe. Only when you believe in your heart that I am a talk show host, I can inspire people positively. I can inspire people. I can educate people. I can motivate people. I can tell my story that is going to change people's life to add value to their life. That is when you are discovering your purpose, because everybody has been created and made for a purpose. And the moment you begin to realize this, the earlier for you, the earlier you begin to realize it, the better for you, I mean. Okay? So yes, prayer is the key. Yes, thank you, girls. Please ask your guy what he have in mind, if he's ready to have a child. Don't use that to hold any man, because I can change city. And because of it, still ask my friend how far if you have the child. Let me see, you wrote as yeah, I can change city, because if still ask my friend how far if you have the child. Last I will still show up because it's my first. Yes, okay, Azu is saying that girls should please take caution to ask a guy first if the guy is interested in having okay, that's a relationship of coming to the extent of having a child with you, to become parents, to parent a child with you. Because he may change city, and then you're pretending you got pregnant, you're pretending you're not telling him you're pregnant, and you're not telling him the situation of things, or you're not telling him if you're seeing another guy. So, and also, what I understand from it is because I can change city, yes, if he relocates to another city, how can you contact him? How far if you have the child, last I will accept. So he says he's going to accept his pregnancy because it's his first fruit, of course, which is the advice from me. Abortion. Don't tell a girl, oh, I know one pregnancy, yo. I be no one pregnancy, I be one just have fun. So now you can't get pregnant, you done your own. No, you have to take caution. You have to be responsible, because when you were going into that girl and pouring your sperm in her, you should know that this thing can result to anything. It could result to pregnancy, okay? The most thing you're scared of is the most you should take as risk. You're scared of impregnating a girl, then do not take the risk of sleeping with a girl without protection. And then if you slept with her with protection and it happens that the protection along the line failed you people, then think about it as, you know, good friends, good brothers and sisters, or relations who can, you know, think about it. But don't decide within the both of you to say, I'm going to abort this baby. Because some of you do abortions, and then when you settle down, you want to get married, you don't have children anymore. You begin to send a winch from your village, or now this one. Or meanwhile, you forgot when you were going to do so many numerous abortions that is going to stop you from having a child. You forgot when you were going to these doctors to abort those children because the father, because it was a rape, because it was this, because it was that. And then you lose all your eggs that are going to make you to have child in your future, you know. So when you're married to a family, maybe there are royals in the family, and you have to provide them with a boy child who's going to take over the throne, who's going to be a successor to the father. What are you going to say? What are you going to do? You don't know your future, so do not take laws into your hand by going into abortions. And also do not go as far as wanting to tame a guy with pregnancy, okay? So many guys are untamed. You can't tame a guy. You can't tame them, okay? They are so flexible. They can be, a guy can be here with you, fucking you, and then he's thinking about another guy or another girl. Same goes for the women. So if you don't know those somebody so well, do not trust them to say, I want to hook him with pregnancy so that he's going to propose to me. I want to do this so that he's going to do that. Okay, because that does not pay. That only shows that you're desperate and you don't love yourself. Because if you love yourself, you should be able to stay by yourself without wanting another guy to validate you by pregnancy or to say, okay, now you're pregnant, I'm going to introduce you to my parents. If he never introduced you to his parents or you were not pregnant and you people never planned about pregnancy, what makes you think all of a sudden, okay, now he's happy you got pregnant for him, he told his parents, but it turned out you're not pregnant. So what is all this nonsense? It doesn't make sense at the end of the day. So just be genuine, be real, be authentic, and keep it 100% real, just like the King Lady. You're not pregnant, you're not pregnant. Sometimes you add weight, people make assumptions. Oh, she may be pregnant because she has a boyfriend. She may be pregnant. If whatever they say, say yes. Oh, yes, I am. Because if you can't start explaining yourself to everybody. You understand? It's even better when you're pregnant, keep it to yourself. Until the guy begins to ask, ah, your body, they change, you're waiting, they happen, this, that, that, that. Then you say yes, because then you are really sure. Not when you're not sure. Or you try to hold him, you know what, you can't go lie, put on. So now you have ruined everything. If he was going to marry you, he's going to have a second thought. He's going to say, man, this girl is not trustworthy. I cannot trust her, you know. And then when you get pregnant, he's going to doubt you still. He's going to say, yeah, the first time you were not pregnant, but now you told me you're pregnant. How can I believe you? I don't trust you. You know what I'm saying? So always keep it real. Keep it 100%, okay? So now, that's the topic for today. I have to go and attend to my kids. It's Sunday and we have a lot to do, okay? All right, bye. Share this video. If you like this video, please share it and tag your friends to follow these topics. I need to drink water, okay? Bye-bye. Love you guys. Bye.